I studied for a level 4 diploma in healthcare science provided by CSR training and scientific group. While in full-time employment with Salisbury NHS Foundation Trust, since the course I have spent one day a week studying, while the remainder of my working week is all about my day-to-day job, all while putting what I have learned into practice. My apprenticeship allows me to work as a healthcare science associate at a band 4 level within the NHS. If I do want to progress further, then further study would be required in the form of a level 6 degree. I believe that it is a constantly evolving field of work, which involves much research, new technology and equipment. It also has a technical side to it, which I enjoy. And in addition, I believe that it also combines a patient-facing role with the technical aspect of running investigations and making diagnoses. To initially obtain an entry-level job within this field, which I was able to do within the NHS trust that I work for. If you go on to enjoy the role and the area of work, then get some experience under your belt and then talk to your manager to see what opportunities exist for your career progression and professional development, which could be in the form of apprenticeships or other science programs that may be available to you. The willingness and ability to learn things quickly, the ability to cope under stress, the ability to work towards tight deadlines, the ability to manage work, study and home lives effectively, which can be a challenge at times, especially during busy periods. The ability to critically reflect on your own practice is also important. And the ability to keep up to date with your own professional development as well. I believe that the best way for people to enter the field of healthcare science is to regularly check certain job websites. For example, we have the NHS jobs website for entry level or trainee positions. In addition to discussing potential opportunities for career development with a prospective employer. However, for those who already have a healthcare science degree or a diploma, I would recommend that they apply for the STP, the Scientist Training Program, which is a much advanced program where you work and study towards a master's degree. In my case, the training has been structured over a period of 2 years. 25% of my weekly work time is allocated towards study. In the first year of the program, I studied units that were mandatory and not necessarily focused on my area of specialty. For example, I learned about the NHS constitution, the structure of the healthcare science workforce, leadership and teaching, etc. And the second year of the program, I was focused more towards my area of specialty, in my case, cardiology, where the subjects are more focused and in depth. My workload during the course has been quite intense, as there have been many instances where I have been given several tasks or projects to complete in a short amount of time. So time management is really essential. I have received support both from my line manager at work, colleagues at work, and from my course tutor, of course. We have quarterly one-to-one reviews where my tutor will review my work and activity over the previous months And the discussions have been open and have proved extremely helpful. I would say that one of the advantages of completing an apprenticeship program over the training schemes is that it is relatively easy to get into if you can show a lot of determination and interest. It is more readily available to everyone, regardless of their status or educational level. Another advantage is that as you can continue to work while you're studying, you do continue to get paid, which comes in very handy. As far as disadvantages are concerned, one of them is that you do not have as much time for study when compared with someone who studies full time, and there may well be better paid opportunities available if someone were to study full time rather than for an apprenticeship. My role within the NHS is a healthcare science associate. I am involved in cardiac investigations. So while it is a patient-facing role, it also has a strong element of technical knowledge and expertise. On my daily basis, I teach other junior members of staff throughout the hospital. For example, I teach them how to perform 12-lead ECGs on patients, and I help to supervise the cardiographers within the department. I also assist my senior colleagues with stress echo testing, tilt table testing, and I help to fit and analyze ambulatory 24-hour ECG monitors, 7-day ECG monitors, and blood pressure monitors. I also perform daily checks on our equipment, ensuring that the resuscitation equipment is ready to be used in case of an emergency. My days are not always the same, but in a typical day, I would start by checking the resuscitation equipment within our department, of course. Then I would participate in a staff briefing. According to the weekly plan that has been set out, I would interact with patients. For example, I would help the cardiographers to perform ECGs and fit ECG monitors. I would also interact with other members of staff from both within our department and other departments and wards across the hospital by offering test results. I also interact with GP surgeries and other consultants, especially when analyzing ECG monitors, as I would have to send the results in the form of reports to these requesters, individuals. We have been very busy during the pandemic, as although GP referrals have decreased somewhat, hospital admissions have increased, and we have had many inpatients to look after and perform investigations on. We were also able to catch up with a lot of our existing work that has been going on within the department. In addition to this, we have also helped other departments across the hospital and volunteered to perform certain tasks to our trust during quieter moments. For example, helping the communications team in helping communicate important messages to the various departments and wards across the hospital during the pandemic. My course has continued as normal, as it has been run online. So there have been many assignments to complete, and I was kept busy. It contributes towards better public health and provides much health research, which is valuable towards the wider community. It helps with the development of new and better ways of performing diagnostics and therapy, new medication, and helps to bring the cost of treatment down in the long term. I highly value the aspect of personalized medicine, which is still quite a new concept to many, But I believe that in the long term, we will see better targeted therapies and treatments being introduced and used within the NHS. In my specialty, technology has evolved quite a lot in recent years, which helps to offer better and quicker diagnoses, which then goes on to increase life expectancy for our patients. We can see that cardiocatheterization has evolved recently, which means that it is now much less invasive than conventional bypass surgery. We can also see that patients can recover from treatment much quicker than before. We have modern ECG monitors and pacemaker equipment, and now we can remotely supervise patients from the comfort of their own home, with patients only needing to attend a clinical appointment at the hospital when the ECG or the pacemaker monitoring consider that it is necessary. That is an interesting question. One instance that I can think of is when we were given a task whereby we had to perform an audit relating to a particular task within our department. I chose one task and performed audit with full backing of my line manager, of course, to check if our KPIs were within specified targets. KPI meaning key performance indicator. As part of this, I had to gather and analyze data, interact with patients, follow their journey through the department from referral through to discharge. And then I had to discuss the results of the audit to the rest of the department, where I was able to make some recommendations to improve the existing KPIs. All of this was then written up into a report and submitted for my course. Then 6 months later, again, as part of my course, I had to perform a re-audit to see if those changes had been implemented and upheld, and to make further suggestions as and when necessary. I am pleased to say that the re-audit showed that my suggestions had been implemented and upheld, and no further changes were required. The audit I performed was greatly welcomed by my line manager, and they welcomed my insight, my analysis and recommendations, all of which have helped to improve the service that we offer to our patients.